In last week's tutorial, we took a look at Excel's header and footer feature. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create a mini Visual Basic routine that's going to link your Excel page headers, so which is this one right here, to a specific cell. Okay, so what we want to do is this. The header should be on the top left-hand side, so it should be right here. It should be linked to cell A2 of each sheet, and it should be visible once the sheet is printed. Now, if you ever tried to do this, you have probably noticed that you can't use formulas inside that header dialog box. So I can show you right here. If we go to page layout and click on this icon to see the full page setup, under header footer, custom header, for the left one, right, we're interested in the left, you can't put equals and then do a cell reference here. Or even put like A2. Because if I do that, it's just stuck as A2, it's just text. To overcome this, we can create a macro. But there are two questions to answer here. One is, how do we want to run that macro? Do we want to create a button and we press that button every time before we print? And the second question is, what are the objects and properties that are involved here? Right, how do we find that? Well, for the first question, how do we want to run this macro? We could always attach that macro to a button. The only thing is that we might forget to click that button before we print, right? So it would be good if Excel just figures it out before it prints. And the good news is that there is an event for this, and it's called the before print event. And this event runs just before your document is printed. Okay, so that's going to take care of our first question. The second question is, how do we find the properties? Let's just record a macro for that and see what type of properties we get. So let's go to the developer tab and click on record macro. I'm just going to go with the defaults. All I need from this macro is to get the syntax that I need for my macro. Let's go to page layout, to page setup, header footer, custom header. And right here, I'm just going to type in something to activate this and something that I can find in the macro recorder again. Say, okay, okay. Let's go back and stop the recording. Let's bring up Visual Basic Editor, Alt F11. So my macro must be right here. And you can see it recorded all of this stuff that was in that dialog box. I'm not interested in any of this except this one. And this one, and this one, and this one, right? So this is the object that I need. It's the active sheet. Its property is page setup, and I need the left header. So I'm gonna copy this part and use it in my macro. And I mentioned earlier that there is an event for this called the before print event. This belongs to this workbook object. From this dropdown, I'm gonna click on workbook. The default event for that is open. We don't want the default. We want before print, and that's right here. Okay, so I can get rid of this one. Now, let me just paste that. So we have it. Now, we do want to loop through each single sheet, right? So let's dim SH as worksheet. Now we want to say for each SH, in this workbook.worksheets, but I'm in the workbook objects. I could actually reference it by me.worksheets. Let's just close that loop. Next SH. So this one goes in here, but I can just say sh.pageSetup.leftHeader equals, we want it to be cell A2. So that's going to be sh.range A2.value. Okay, and we have next SH. Okay, so that's it. Now, the thing is that if I go to print preview, let's see what we see here. We still see the old one. This macro is going to run the moment I press print, right? And then I'll see it in the printed out version. I'm pointing that way because my printer's there. If I print this to PDF, we can see it in the PDF. Actually, I can try that right now. Let's export it to PDF. We save it right there. Let me just open up the PDF. Okay, and we can see that the header is actually changing header text, which is what I have in cell A2 here. Okay, so if I go back to my Excel, now if I go and do print preview, I can see it in here as well. Okay, so for some reason, this print preview doesn't run that macro. Now, the thing is that in the old Excel versions, there used to be another type of print preview, and that runs it. And you can get to that type from the quick access toolbar. So we can add it there, and then I can show it to you. So if I go to more commands, and it's not a popular command, it's actually a command not in the ribbon, and go all the way down to P. Okay, we can see there are two print previews. One is print preview and print, so that's the one that I have right now. And the other one is print preview full screen. Okay, now if you remember that old Excel, this might look familiar to you. Okay, so if we use this, this one is going to run our macro. Now we've already ran it, so just to demonstrate to you, let me just change what we have here. Let's also add something else to this. Let's add today's date. I'm gonna do and, let's make some distance between them. So VB tab, and let's just put in date. Okay, so if I go to the normal print preview, okay, I don't see the date yet. Now when I click this one, you see it's just taking a little bit longer. It's running my macro and I see it here. Okay, now if I go back to the normal print preview, I see it here as well. But just know that even if you don't see it in the normal print preview, the moment you press that print button, you're going to see it in the printed out version. Let's also just check that it does work for different sheets. So let me see if I have something on A2 here. And this one, I also have something on A2. Now I'm going to highlight these three sheets and let's go to the print preview. Okay, so I can see that is what I have in A2. Let's go to the next page. This is what I have here together with the date and the next one. And I have this as well. Okay, so this is how you can use the before print event to create dynamic headers for your Excel files.